driving. Why is he always me?
Every morning, same routine, we play our little family game. No one knows where Austin is, and guess who always gets the blame?
Oh, I'm an apprentice. community for health and safety.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Connie, can I get paid sitting in union meetings during Kim T?
You read the union rule book.
Yeah, I have. It was really
put a song in it, Beryl.
It's true.
All morning, me and Monty have been at the pay review committee.
Yeah, yeah.
We've been asking for a re-evaluation of our grading.
Right.
Normie is to make sure Connie signs those new job evaluation
right.
schemes.
Right.
Are we getting a pay rise or not?
Yeah.
Alright, to cut a long story short, ladies, you got graded B.
Oh, well, that's not good, then, isn't
it? No, it ain't.
What?
An unskilled grade.
Ah, you can't
expect us to agree to that.
Who else has signed up to this?
All of me. The AEWU.
I don't care. The RAC, the IOU, the PMT have signed it. Yeah. We're not signing it. No, I ain't working. Unskilled initiative.
No, it's indefensible.
So why'd you agree to it then?
I didn't. I was outvoted by the mayor.
Oh, wow. So it's not me.
Girls, come on, all right. I know what you want, all right?
No, you don't. We want templates for this leather bed.
Yeah, and new machines. Not saying this one's old or nothing. But the manual is in fucking Latin.
Right, fine. What do you want?
I want a chair that you just don't create.
Come on, there can be no secrets in the revolution, comrade.
Look, me and Connie were a long time back.
Yeah, all right then. Oh, no, I was wearing that shirt, eh? Beryl, eh?
Oh, come on, Bill, she's serious. Connie, she ain't happy.
Yeah, and I'm not sneezy. Look, are you saying that the wrong sign? I represent 2,000 engineers, 1,000 fitters, and every one of them's got a proper man's airy arse. It's only young 200 effing women that are effing it up. Oh, shit, management. Where's Hawkins? I must have had the yanks on the blur. Are we made him in?
Oh, problem, Hawkins.
Yeah, it's because you're a bourgeois revenant running dog.
How was that like you?
You're not West End.
Hawkins. What's this I'm hearing about the NUVB not signing off a new brace?
Oh, my boys have signed it, it's the girls.
Monty?
Well, yes, sir, all right, the girls are not happy about being downgraded.
Who would be? But it's your job, Monty, to convince them of the bigger picture, management, union. It's a long game.
It's test match cricket.
It's a game of give and take. You see, you scratch my back.
And I scratch yours, and what a lovely back it is, Mr. Hawkins,
yeah,
sir.
Yeah, thank you, Bill. Look, it's a done deal. The men have all signed off. The vote was overwhelming.
Yeah, 5,000 men, 200 women.
You can't win, Monty. Your hands are tied. Your balls are in a Kenwood chef.
Yes, sir, but it's my job to represent the women. But come on, isn't that like procedural wars we can do? Stop things coming to an end.
Any ideas, Bill?
Well, suppose we could always confuse the poor donors with some totally incomprehensible bollocks.
Like the grievance procedure.
Oh, well, the grievance procedure was Connie's idea. She'll have to comply.
That's brilliant. But tomorrow morning we'll have a meeting. Head office, Wally.
Oh, afternoon.
Bernie.
After you, sir.
Thank you.
Go on then. Off course, Monty. Come on over. Hey, if you're not back in half an hour, we'll drag the river, eh?
Oh, mate, it sounds funny.
Management.
Bastards.
I'm going to insist on registering formal grievance.
Oh, sorry. Hang on. I just thought, what about the girls in Dunton?
Yeah, they did the same job as us.
The girls at Dunton anonymously got graded six skilled. Tomorrow, all right? Me, you know, Bill.
No, I don't want Bill. I want one of the girls.
Yeah,
take Beryl.
Okay, she can do the spell. You can't take Beryl, she can start a
fight.
And now we're here. That's all I
I make myself clear?
Yeah.
loud and airing our blokes sweating away, and in less than a woman.
Ladies and gentlemen, Charlie Chaplin, and I'm here to tell you a story. So, I took the mother-in-law on safari the other year. She got attacked by three of those lions. Wife goes, ain't you gonna help her? I'm like, nah, three should be enough. No, but seriously, she's a big lady, as a mother-in-law. She tried one of those gymnasium things though. Went on the rowing machine and the damn thing sank. I didn't try to be nice, right? I had her for dinner the other night, but I had one of those Freudian slip things. What I meant to say was, can you please pass the butter? But what came out was, you've ruined my life, you fat ugly bitch.
Every breath. towels or chocolate or some stupid cuddly toy. I'm just a man with a foolish brain. I promise that I'll never forget again. The sucker punched my soul. Without you, I'm not whole. There ain't a single thing I can do. I'm sorry, but
Think of it.
I'm sorry.
Tired of it.
I'm sorry.
I've had enough.
I'm sorry.
Oh, come on, Ed.
I'm sorry.
Think of it.
S-I-C-K. S-M-R-R-Y. I'm shouting from the rooftop. I'm screaming to the horse. Everything is mine and yours, apart from my before. Tell me just how many times you want me to tell you. How many times I'm sorry, but I love the 92. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but I love you.
I'm sorry. It's just rather funny because most people can't speak in Latin.
So you're quite happy for your son to be physically abused by a sadist?
Yes, it's an expensive public school. I'd be disappointed if he wasn't being abused. I remember when I was a lad. We played rugby. We lost 73-0, believe me, we were lucky to get that. So the teacher gave us six of the best on the hand. On the hand. Believe me, that hurts. Anyway, darling, what do you have planned for the day? What? Tupperware party, perhaps?
I thought I'd wash up, do the ironing, put
polished off a couple of bottles of vodka and set fire to the Women's Institute.
Sounds lovely, darling. Sounds lovely, really.
That's... Oh, you weren't listening, were you?
No, sorry. Sorry.
Look, I just want to know what you expect me to do all day in the middle of the Essex countryside.
Now, don't start. Not now.
When is the time?
Look, I bought you a horse.
It doesn't like me.
Snuggles. I'm going through a lot of pressure right now. Work. I need you to stand by me. Well, fine, I've got to go. Trouble at mill.
Let me guess, Mrs. O'Grady.
Yeah, well done.
How can I help?
I'm not... What I wanted to say is, have you been caning my son?
Yes.
Oh, so you admit it then.
An integral element of an elite education is discipline. Ergo.
Ergo? That Latin then, is it?
Yes, it means therefore. Ergo, it's incumbent on me to cane your son to restrain his natural recalcitrance.
I don't know what those words mean either.
He's insolent. He kicks against tradition. Like most of the scholarship boys, he conforms to the current fashion of individualism, which is antithetical to the core values of the school.
It ain't right. He's a child. Ergo, I don't want you caning him.
Well, I'm afraid your outrage is misplaced.
My outrage?
Do you want your son to go to college? Sixth form? University, I do. Are you saying you would be happier if you left at 16 and got a job in a factory? I don't know if you've ever been in a factory,
but... I work in a factory.
Well, then you should know better. Is there anything else that I can help you with?
No.
Oh, excuse me.
Oh, piss off.
I'm sorry, I thought you was a teacher. It's Mr. Button, he's been caning my boy.
Mine too. That's why I'm here.
Rita O'Grady, Lisa Hopkins.
I like that dress.
Thanks, it's Bieber.
Someone should do something about it.
The caning, not the dress. The dress is lovely, it's perfect. Don't touch that.
Sorry, I go all weird when I'm in the hump.
Look, we should start a petition. What do you think, shall we?
Oh, I don't know. Not very political.
Oh, it's not politics. I'm not asking you to stand for Parliament. This is cruelty. Us parents should stand up to him.
Right. Well, good luck with that one. I've got to go.
So, Barbara, you've had those lovely legs of yours under the desk for a week now. Who do you blame for this country's pitiful record of industrial productivity?
Well, the problem as I see it is we have to get our people to go to work and stay there. We need a no-strike agreement with the TUC.
Are you mad, woman? I told you the Labour Party is dependent on the TUC.
This isn't easy for me either. This is tearing me apart. This is my draft white paper in place of strife. We have to ban strikes!
We can't ban strikes! The TUC have 6 million block votes at the Labour Party conference. They bought me this pipe. They paid for my holidays in the Sicily island. They underlaid in my bathroom.
But how
are we... No, Barbara, you've got this all wrong. I'm going. Call me back when you have a solution.
Dockers, miners, train drivers, dinner ladies. I don't care if the TUC strike when the Tories are in. That's where Labour, they're pissing on their own doorstep.
What about management? They have to take responsibility. It takes two to tango.
Don't try and bamboozle me with choreography. I don't care if you're Prime Minister, Prime Minister. You gave me this job. You have to let me do it my way, or else I'll turn on you. And you wouldn't want that. So I'm like a she-lion. Have you ever seen a she-lion take down a wildebeest?
A wildebeest? I'm from Huddersfield.
Bye, Prime Minister. Men.
It all sounds nice. I just can't picture any of it.
Right.
Headache?
Yeah.
You're lying?
Yeah.
Oi! Get some!
Why is Monty sitting with us?
He stays at the hotel next door.
Hotel? He only lives in Barking!
You don't understand expenses, do you, love?
So, go on then. Did you and Monty ever?
Once. Scarborough, 9:53. Labour Party conference.
But only once. You learn from your mistake then, yeah?
Yeah. Don't drink and operate heavy machinery.
Oh, it's all going off behind the curtain. Oh,
Rita!
Sorry. So, why didn't you ever marry?
Monty?
Well, I don't know. He can't have been the only single fella in Essex.
Yeah. Well, he was a good dancer, but I didn't love him. Besides, I'd already married the Labour Party and a lassie husband they turned out to be.
He was trying to save the world.
Yeah, I didn't want to be my mum. The drudge, the grind, low wages, factory work.
Oh, come on, Colin. You can't be in a mood when you're in the Burnley Inn. You did good. You got a grievance procedure.
A grievance procedure ain't changing the world. Yesterday when I started out, I knew it all. I had no doubt. Love is there in front of me, just for you, you want to be. Start work way too young, same as all the blokes. Worked our fingers to the bone, making do by making jokes. But now I'm older, looking back it doesn't seem so funny. Same work, same hours, and half the money. It's an age old story. It's an age-old tale, still the same old reasons that are there to make us fail. Second at the table, picking at the crumbs, change is always promised, but somehow never comes. I joined the Labour Party on the shoulders of the great. Emancipated teenager who didn't have time to wait. Fierce, feisty, full of fight. A warrior, a dreamer. 3 years on, I am still a union convener. You will say to me, stick with it, we need you.
And we do.
What did I achieve? The grievance procedure. It's an age-old story. It's an age-old tale, still the same old reasons that they make us fail. Always on the outside, kicking at the door. Looks like a glass ceiling from down here on the floor. It's always been a whisper, but can't hear me roar. All those silent voices that won't tell. So please wake up, I need you to see. It ain't a price of money, it's equality. This doesn't just have to be about C grade.
What do you mean?
If we got C grade tomorrow, we'd still be earning less than a man of C grade.
87%? That ain't bad.
Did Martin Luther King ask for 87% of rights for black people?
You do know they shot him.
Rita!
Look, this is about C grade, nothing else. Women have never had equal pay.
And what about your Sharon?
She's 9.
And when she's 29, do you want her to be on 87%?
She wants to be a doctor.
Rita, she could be. Nothing changes if it isn't challenged. You can change the story. You can change the tale. Don't fall for all those reasons. They put there to make us fail. We
huge, isn't it?
Good afternoon.
Right, today we've got the ladies.
Oh.
One of them, Connie Riley, she's a shop steward and she's alright. She knows the procedures. But the other one is a bit of a troublemaker.
The fit.
Sir, please.
Oh, sorry, it was just a joke.
Well, this ain't a joke, alright? They threatened to walk out the other day.
Oh, I'll have to lay off 5,000 men if I don't get a continuous supply of quarantine seats.
Nah, look, alright, we'll part this in the grievance procedure. Connie was instrumental in setting it up. She ain't going to argue against it.
Well, that's brilliant. We've got them under our thumbs, we can do what we like.
Ooh, Mackie.
Mace, these remarks are really not becoming of a production manager.
It was just a joke.
Look, fellas, your management, our union. At the end of the day, we're all meeting. This is our world. Now, the world of work. When we get home in the doghouse.
I ain't going home.
Right, I'll go round them up. Right, ladies. There's two of them, three of us. It's the first fight. Connie's done this before. It's all collective agreements. So I'll just leave you talking to us, eh, Rita?
Yeah, I'm just here to make up the numbers. I'm keeping my mouth shut.
Terrific, this way. Gentlemen, this is Connie Riley, shop steward for River Plant, and this is Rita O'Grady. She does the machinist. Rita, this is Ron Mason, production manager, and Mr. Jeremy Hopkins, the managing director for Fort Dagenham.
Oh, hello! I've never met you before.
Sit down.
The NUVB executive supports the job evaluation process.
True. But my members at River Plant.
The girls?
Yes, the girls. They're reluctant to sign off.
Yeah, Rita.
Well, fortunately, we have the grievance procedure. Due to your efforts in the past, Colin.
Yes, and we do wish to register a formal grievance.
We have no objections to grading grievance hearings being granted under the formally agreed formal grievance procedure.
So you agree to grant the girls their grading grievance on the grounds that their greatest grievance gripes can be grieved in the grievance procedure if they're grave enough. Great, great. We're very grateful.
So when is the next grievance committee?
Hang on. September.
Agreed.
Hang on! I'm not working on grade B for 3 months. No. We're skilled workers!
Well, that's to be discussed in September.
What? You have to take 3 tests before you even get in the door. Ergo, we must be skilled!
Ergo.
Yes, bloody ergo!
Did he take 3 tests?
Of course he tests us, because he can't afford to let anybody loose on his expensive leatherette. And what about the girls in Dunton? They got C grade.
There are only 2 girls at Dunton.
What difference does that make?
The girls at Dunton have to work under pressure.
Under pressure? I have to make 300 pieces a day. You try working with that monkey on your back.
Dunton is a research and development facility. They've got no drawing there.
You think we work from drawings? You go through that shed, you won't find one single template!
Rita?
Don't you read to me, Monty! So well, you're saying we're unskilled then, yeah? Which means you can do our job. That's what you're saying, innit?
So,
what needle would you use for leatherette? Ballpoint or cruel?
Look.
Alright, what would you set your dog teeth on for real leather? Do you know what dog teeth are? Alright, last question. What would you sweep a yard with?
No.
A yard brush.
Oh, congratulations. You could be a cleaner.
How bloody hell.
Listen, we cross-analyse every job role across 28 different characteristics.
Yeah, 28 different characteristics and the bloody sex who does it.
£17 for 40 hours a week.
Oh, don't you insult me. You know what we want. Are you going to give us equal pay or not?
Okay, equal pay.
This ain't about equal pay, honey.
Why isn't it about equal pay?
This was never an equal pay issue.
It wasn't, but it is now.
You made it work.
The grievance procedure was your idea.
15 years ago and you lot have been bleeding and abusing me ever since.
Look, we're going to go, Connie. You can stuff your grievance procedure right where the sun don't shine. It was nice to meet you. A cup of tea would have been nice, but I guess that's skilled work.
Jimmy, morning. Get you on with me, Lola, what?
Yeah.
Put the kettle on, I'm coming over.
Everybody out! Everybody out! Everybody out!
I've left the kids.
What do you say then?
Chips on toast.
Chips on toast? Why?
That could cook chips and I could cook toast.
We're alright, well, you do what you've got.
Everybody out!
Everybody out!